Okay, Top Gun is done. And I pay attention. I try to watch through Quentin Tarantino lens, and I still think he wrong. There is no way that Tom Cruise is gay for any pilot. Only possible gay pilot is this guy Hollywood and this guy Wolfman. In the beginning of the movie, I get a little bit worried. I'm watching, and then all of a sudden, this Hollywood guy make joke. He say they're watching the fighter jet on video, and he say, "Oh, I'm getting hard." And then his partner Wolfman, he say, "Oh, don't tease me." Maybe this just joke, maybe not. I forget this part of the movie, so I'm getting a little bit worried in the beginning. I'm not going to lie, I start to worry. But no, I have enough points on my side against Quentin Theory to make me win the debate. Hollywood and Wolfman, only possible gay pilot, and they do not beat the Russians. They are the first plane shot out of the sky. In the end battle, which is phenomenal, the end action sequence, I love this. They are shot out of the sky right away. The gays do not beat the Russian. So 1 point me, 0 point Tarantino. Next point he say, at the end of the movie after the action, Tom Cruise or Wingman say, or no, Iceman say to Tom Cruise, "You can ride my tail anytime." This is not the right line. Unless my DVD somehow they change with computer because it used to be the line, but Tarantino make the joke, so they change, and I don't think this happened. That's not the right line. They say you can be my wingman anytime. Very different meaning. If I miss the gay joke in the beginning, and then I miss the line at the end, and I miss the rest of these things, okay, maybe Tarantino win, but no. So far, 2 for me, 0 for Quentin. Okay, he say Tom Cruise and Kelly have date, first date at Kelly's house, and everything going very well. But right when you think something might happen, people are getting in the mood, Tom Cruise say, "I'm going to take a shower." And then he just go. He leave on his motorcycle. Quentin think this because he does not want to sleep with women. I think he's being smart. I think he's leaving, making her want more. This is a good technique. It can work. It does not mean he's gay. So another point for me. 3-0. Next point, what else he say? Oh, he say lots of shirtless, sweaty men. I don't feel like I should comment on this subject because I am shirtless, sweaty man. Maybe not my place to talk, but I do not think this mean gay movie. Lots of movie have shirtless, sweaty men. Almost every action movie have some kind of shirtless, sweaty man. Otherwise, women will not watch action movie. Maybe. So yes, another point for me. I do not think this means gay movie. So 4-0. And his next, okay, next one is kind of difficult. After he say, "I have to shower," and he do not sleep with Kelly. Next scene, they meet in elevator, and Kelly is kind of dressed like men. She's, but not really. Everybody wear these clothes in 80s. Everybody dressed the same in the 80s. Boy, girl, they all wear high waist, tight blue jean, and white t-shirt. This is like every person in the 80s. I think any 80s movie star, Bruce Willis, Kim Basinger, like every, I cannot, Richard Gere. I think every 80 movie star wear high waist blue jean and white t-shirt. John Travolta, all of them. So I do not think this means she's dressed like men, but she is wearing hat. She does not wear hat in any other scene in the movie. So, I don't know why, but I think we split this point. I cannot disprove hat. Blue jean, t-shirt, okay, but why the hat? Half point. Okay, fine, take the point. You have one, I have four. Okay, I still think I win, and in my book, Top Gun is definitely a great movie and deserve pop five popcorn bag. That's right, Greg. I say five popcorn bag. What you going to do, huh? I'm coming for your record. I'm going to get it. I will smash it. I will watch all every movie every day. What else? Oh, Meg Ryan is in the movie. I forget she's in this. She's actually very good in this. I forget because she have small part. She play Goose wife. But Goose death, spoiler, is probably one of the best action death or best death in action movie almost ever, because you see him get pulled out of the water with the helicopter. It's very sad. And then Tom Cruise visit Meg Ryan, and they have, oof, very rough scene. It get me a little bit choked up. But she's good, and Goose very good too. Goose, I think the reason his death is so sad is because he's very good in this movie. He's very likable. He's the kind of guy, you know, you don't want to die. But he does. What else? Oh, besides the action ending, the love story ending with Kelly and Tom is actually pretty good. Like, lots of action movies don't really have good love story and kind of corny, but this I like. They tie it together, and they have a callback. It's a music callback. It's nice. I think it worked very well. Anything else? I think this is it. But yeah, Quentin Theory disprove. Top Gun, great movie. And now we do special feature. It's going to be very good. Lots of special feature for a great movie. I cannot wait to hear how they make all these crazy things happen. Let's go.